Hello and welcome to another Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, you will learn about the dashboard application and how to display your data. The dashboard application can be a really useful application. Its purpose is mainly to display different types of data at the same time to an end user. It is widely used in BI applications where different types of data is displayed using graphs, grids, or even index widgets. The way Scriptcase's dashboard works is pretty simple. You just have to create widgets, link your applications that you want to display, and then you can adjust them to your own needs. You can then also link those widgets to other existing applications within your own project, or you can choose to retrieve data directly from your selected database and then by creating index widgets display specific information to your end user. Creating a new application, I will select the dashboard application. I will leave the basic settings available here as default and click the create button. Within the dashboard application, the left settings option is automatically open and a single widget is available. I can then click on add link widget to create a new widget within the dashboard. Clicking the link field will present my available applications which I can use within this dashboard widget. Here I can also select to view only specific types of applications. So I will select only view chart application and select a chart to be displayed. To the top I can configure the toolbar options available within the displayed application and then in properties I can make changes to the widget options. With my new widget added, once I'm ready I can click the save button. With my new widget added, I can then adjust its position using the bottom right widget handle and also the layout by clicking the little edit icon. I can also delete it with the delete button next to that. Let's go ahead and run the dashboard application and see what it currently looks like with the one application displayed and two widgets. So we can see here the dashboard, which I have included. Let's go back to the dashboard application, delete the first widget and adjust the widget I have just added. Okay, if I run the application again, and we should now see that I have one large widget with the chart displayed. Back into Scriptcase, the next kind of widget you can add is the index widget. Now within this widget, you can immediately see a big difference in the options available. The reason being is that this widget is used to connect directly to the project database and display specific data. I will first select the connection I want to use, and then I will select a table. It is important that this table has a metric field as well as a period or date field associated to it. So here I will select, for instance, the price order, and the period field, I will select the order date. I can then apply a metric function as well as a period function. On the next tab, I can change the formatting displayed for the metric values. I can then also provide a filter, and on the next, the layout can also be customized. We can then also specify further properties for the displayed widget. I can fully customize how this widget will be displayed. For instance, I can apply a background color and change the font styling depending on the results that are actually displayed. If I save my widget and then reposition it within the dashboard application and then run the application again, we can then see the final result of our dashboard application with an index widget and background. To learn more about the dashboard application, we have many more videos available on this and various topics, as well as targeted webinars, all available on our website at www.scriptcase.net. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.